Okay, so I think we are trying to derive the equation for the difference in geopotential thickness between two levels. So we got somewhere, we got an expression like this. Rd, Rd by G naught, integral, no P1 to P2 is it? Okay, what is the equation number? Okay, what is the equation number? Okay, so this was the equation we derived in the earlier class. So this is the geopotential thickness level. Geopotential thickness between two pressure levels P1 and P2, correct? Now we will look at the concept of scale height and the hypsometric equation. Okay. If TV is so very close to T, so this will become okay. So this or we will change it to okay, we will stay with this, or you can change it to RT by G naught integral P2 to P1 and take care of the minus sign, whichever way it's comfortable. Okay. So now this RT, we are trying to figure out the units of this in the earlier class. Now we'll just clean this up. So this R was joules, this was Kelvin. Okay. Goes. Let's take this fellow. Kilogram meters per second squared. Correct? People were saying it is dimensionless and all that in the morning. I also thought, I was worrying why the fundas are suddenly getting wacky. Okay. So I have to get a scale. Okay. So this RDT by G naught is called H, the H which is the scale height of the atmosphere. Once you have the scale height Z2 minus Z1, please check whether the minus sign is all right. I have done something here. Okay. So, this form, they are all various forms of the hypsometric equation. The hypsometric equation is also called the thickness equation. That is, it gives you an idea of the thickness between two pressure levels P1 and P2. Okay. So, if you know the scale A to the atmosphere a priori, and you know the two levels Z1 and Z2, if we start with the pressure P1, it is possible for you to calculate the pressure at the level corresponding to Z2. If you know what, okay, if you know the two levels Z2 and Z1. Now let us work further on this. What is that? H. Yeah, what is this value? (29.3 T). So between the stratosphere and troposphere, you can assume a mean value of the temperature of the atmosphere to be 255 Kelvin. Somewhere between troposphere and stratosphere. What will the value of H be? So H becomes 7.5 kilometers. So, 7.5 kilometers is a good estimate of the scale height of the atmosphere. Okay, that's something which you have learnt in today's class. Now, what is the story? This is troposphere and stratosphere and all this. Beyond turbopause, what about mixing beyond turbopause? Mixing is very less. Okay. So this vertical distribution is mostly controlled by molecular diffusion. Okay. So what? What is the big deal? If mixing is very limited beyond the turbopause, and the vertical distribution is controlled only by molecular diffusion, it is possible for you to define the H for every species. Okay. For each gas, what is the relationship between this H for each gas and the molecular weight? H we will find heavier gases at the top or lighter gases at the top? Lighter gases at the top. So, for the heavier gases, the concentration will exponentially decay very quickly, right? So, the lighter gases have a chance to escape, like hydrogen, correct? Okay. So, this is so far as this hypsometric equation in scale height is concerned. Now, no, that ozone is somewhere, it is coming only in between. No? So, not all gases are present at all levels. We are talking about at 100 kilometers, whatever is present, its distribution will be characterized by this. This equation is not applicable for troposphere. Okay. I already told you that it is only in the stratosphere. Ozone is maximum only in the stratosphere. Okay. So, we have lot of problems in today's class. Problem number 16. At a geopotential, please take down problem number 16. At a geopotential height of 200 kilometers above the Earth's surface, a typical quiz question. Okay. At a geopotential height of 200 kilometers above the Earth's surface, the ratio of the number density of oxygen atoms to that of hydrogen atoms is 10 to the 5. Calculate this ratio at a geopotential height of 1300 kilometers. At a geopotential height of 200 kilometers above the Earth's surface, the ratio of the number density of oxygen atoms to that of hydrogen atoms is 10 to the power of 5. Calculate this ratio at a geopotential height of 1300 kilometers. Please assume an isothermal atmosphere between 200 and 1300 kilometers to make the problem tractable. Assume an isothermal atmosphere between 200 and 1300 kilometers with a uniform temperature of 2000 Kelvin. Okay, temperatures will be very high, right? It is much above all this turbopause and all. Okay, anyway, we are going to do the math and solve the problem. Before that, do you expect that ratio to come down or? It will come down drastically. Correct. So, we just now saw oxygen is much heavier compared to hydrogen. It has got a very high ratio, that is for every hydrogen atom you have 10 to the power of 5 oxygen atom at the ground. At 200 kilometers you just nobody can survive. In fact, at 44,000 feet, that is 43,000 feet is the service ceiling for most commercial jetliners. 44,000 feet. You just the cabin is exposed to the outside for a few seconds, all people will die. There won't be enough oxygen. Okay, so there is one theory about this MH17, no? MH370 event beyond 43,000 feet and all. Okay, the service ceiling for example, the Boeing 777-300ER and so on, is 43,100 feet. Okay. The pilot has to ensure that he stays below that level all the time, okay, even on a transatlantic or a transpolar flight. Okay, please solve this problem. Problem number 16. So, when you fly in an airplane, the cabin has to be pressurized to get enough oxygen. It cannot be at the same pressure as the outside. Oxygen will be very low. Okay. Of course, temperature here, the pilot has to heat the inside. Outside temperature will be minus 52 degrees centigrade at a height of 12 kilometers from mean sea level. Okay. Problem number 16. So, let me start off. The first step is the most difficult step. A lot of you have ignition trouble. Okay. So, P 1300 of oxygen divided by P, 200 kilometers I told you that after 100 kilometers you can define a H for each of these, okay. Z2 minus Z1, what is Z2 minus Z1? 1000, yeah, minus, that is equal to, yes, correct. So please note it is in kilometers. Okay, so O2 write a similar equation for, write a similar equation for hydrogen, divide one equation by the other. P200 of oxygen divided by P200 of hydrogen is 10 to the power of 5, already given, okay. Now I have given, right, I have given it to you. So work out a relationship with which you will be able to get P1300 of oxygen divided by P1300 of what is that, hydrogen, as a function of only the H of oxygen and the H of hydrogen. So the last two steps involve the calculation of the scale height for oxygen and hydrogen. Substitute all the values, plug it in your formula, then you will get the result. Please do it. So P now I do 3 divided by 4. Any problem? Is giving strange results or no? No, no. That is Calci problem then. So P divided by, this will be P200 1 by H2 minus or plus? H2 minus. 1 by H? Yes, Swajit, is it okay? H? Very good. Okay. Now, what we want is this, right? This is what we want. This I gave you, okay? This and this, if you calculate, you are done. Let us do that. What is H of O2? RD RD by G naught. How much is this? Take care of this. This equation is in kilometers. H is in kilometers. How much is this?
What is the problem? 53 kilometers?
Sir, why is it
255?
Huh?
2000. The temperature will be 2000 K.
Yeah. That hangover of the 255 from the 2000. Yes. How much is this? I got something. 8314. Oxygen is 62 or
32
or 16.
O2, that's
right. O2 molecule. You mentioned oxygen atom.
No, it's cupping. So this has to be O, then I will say O. Hang on. H. No problem. No sweat. Both are random, no? But this 1/H minus that will give you get bad. So okay. So let's make it 16. I get some 103 kilometers something. Okay, fine. 106 kilometers, very good. That is too bad. The normal atmosphere, when you are looking troposphere and stratosphere, is what is the scale height? 7.5. Scale height is too much. Then H of, or you will put H of oxy, whatever. Okay. So H is 8314 by 1, It's too much. Okay. Now, this is 5, 6, 7, 8, okay. Substituting for what was this?
1/10.
1/10.
Wait.
10 O by H. 10 to the power of plus 5 or minus 5? At a J potential, the ratio. Okay, P. I got it. At okay. Now please tell me into. That's very good. E to the power of minus 1100. One by. One by 106. You can pack that 1695. It won't contribute anything. Correct? It'll be just a 10th or a 20th of that. Okay, how much is this? Huh? 10 per? 5. Simple. 6, huh? Okay. Very nice. Okay. So the ratio is only 6. Though this is 16:1. So the ratio is oxygen is in really bad supply. At those places. Bye. Very small with respect to the 10 to the power of 5 with which you started out. Okay. Viswajit, are you checking? You check, no problem. So, what is the bottom line? What is the take home message from this problem? Oxygen concentration rapidly decreases with height. Okay. Now, you cannot, we have just used T. The original scale height and hypsometric equations are the TV was inside the integral. It is not possible for you to always neglect this variation and then just say that TV equal to T and put it and pull it out of the integral. It cannot always be neglected. Okay. So, I think now what I am going to write is the more general hypsometric equation. So, we have to define TV bar So, you will have to define a mean virtual temperature which is called TV bar, which is given by integral P2 to P1 TV d of ln P divided by P2 to P1 d of ln P. What is this? Ln? Yes, this is ln. Okay, so keep this result now. We go back to the equation numbers when we started out today's class. Is it this will be 22 or 23? 22. Okay, let's stay with 22. Okay, so what we are saying is generally that TV equal to T will not work. So this is the more general form. Now compare this with your original equation. What was your original equation? like, let me see, where is the original equation? Okay, so we had this equation. Correct? The D of ln p can be taken as, is it okay? What is D of ln p? dp by p, right? Okay. Now please help me. You've got this. Integral p2 to p1 tv dp by p is nothing but tv bar into ln p1 by p2. This one, if you substitute here, then you will get this thickness equation where the tv bar is considered or factored in. Is it okay? So substituting for So substituting for this thing from equation 22, what do you get? What can this be called? H bar, very good. So this is a average scale height. So I stand corrected. So Z2 minus Z1 is H ln P1 by P2 is also some form of hypsometric equation. The correct form of the hypsometric equation is this. Okay, this is the original undiluted hypsometric equation. It is also called the thickness equation because it gives an expression for the thickness of the geopotential height, okay, with the scale height and the ratio of the two pressures. It is a fundamental equation in atmospheric science. 24. All right. Problem 17. So let's move on to problem number 17. Please take down this problem. Calculate the geopotential height of the 990 hPa pressure surface. Calculate the geopotential height of the 990 hPa pressure surface if the pressure at sea level is 1014 hPa. Calculate the geopotential height of the 990 hPa pressure surface if the pressure at sea level is 1014 hPa hectopascal. The scale height of the atmosphere may be assumed to be 7.5 kilometers. Simple. So please apply the hypsometric equation. When I say scale height now, is it H or H bar?
H bar.
H bar, very good. So the H bar is 7.5. Apply the hypsometric equation. Everything is given to you, right? What is the Z at sea level? Oh, very good. Z at sea level is?
Zero.
Huh? 1014 by, yeah? How much is it? 182 meters. Okay. So we need not say pressure is 990 hpa. I am talking about a cloud or something at 182 meters means it corresponds to pressure of 990 hpa. So pressure and Z are mutually interchangeable, that is the important thing in atmospheric science. So the Z can be used as a proxy or a Z can be used as a surrogate or a proxy for pressure, because that you using the hydrostatic equation you know the relationship between this. We can also do it, I have a very, because this P naught is very close to the, P naught is very close to the 990, there is, it is possible for you to, is this correct? What is ln of 1 plus? Huh? What is ln of 1 plus x when x is much much smaller than
x?
This is equal to, this is not required. If you have the calculator, you can go ahead, but I want to look at the asymptotic limit and look at what happens into. How much are you getting this way? Before calculators were invented, people would have used such methods like this. In fact, the calculator does that. Instead of stopping with, it takes, it is an expansion. Everything is an expansion. Okay, so this is a smart way of doing. You may not agree with this statement, but I think it is a smart way of doing it. So around 180 meters is 990. So for 250, I can also have the question as at 300 meters Z, what will be the pressure? Okay. Or 900 hpa, what will be the Z? So you can have questions. You can go from Z to P or P to Z. Okay. Now, we have to look at thicknesses and heights of constant pressure surfaces. Is this fine? Okay. As height increases, the pressure decreases. So P is inversely proportional to Z. So pressure surfaces. A pressure surface is an imaginary surface which connects all the points having the same pressure. So no two pressure surfaces can intersect in the atmosphere. Is that okay? Just like two streamlines cannot intersect, two pressure surfaces cannot intersect. It's a very important concept. Two pressure surfaces also Z2 minus Z1 is proportional to TV, correct? As TV increases, the air between the two pressure levels expands and therefore the layer becomes thicker or thinner. The layer becomes thicker. I come again. As the temperature increases, the air will expand. So between two pressure levels, the air will become thicker. People who are frowning and who cannot digest what I am saying, you will digest after we work out problem number 18. Okay? Yes. So this will be the last problem for today's class. After we do this, we are done. Okay? Please take down this problem. Calculate the thickness of the layer. Calculate the thickness of the layer between the 1000 and 600 HPa pressure surfaces. I am giving you two situations. One is the tropics where the mean virtual temperature of the layer is 16 degrees centigrade, and the second one corresponds to the polar regions where the corresponding mean virtual temperature is minus 40 degrees. So I will dictate the problem fully. Calculate the thickness of the layer between the 1000 and 600 HPa pressure surfaces A at a point in the tropics where the mean virtual temperature of the layer is 16 degrees centigrade. At a point in the tropics where the mean virtual temperature of the layer is 16 degrees centigrade, and B at a point in the polar regions, at a point in the polar regions where the corresponding mean virtual temperature is minus 40 degrees centigrade. In both the cases, P2 and P1 are 1000 and 600, they are the same. The funda here is the TV is different. Work it out. We will just take a couple of minutes. So Z2 minus Z1 G0 into ln of, very good, yes, yes. RD is 287. 9.81, P1 is 1000, okay. So you have to do smart work. This is a constant for both part A and part B. So get a general relationship where Z2 minus Z1 is a function only of TV, okay. So Z2 minus Z1. Yes, please help me. What is this ln of 1000 by? What is the value? 14 point? 14.94, very good, okay. How much is this? This will be in kilometer, huh? Don't forget. H is in kilometer. I hope so. Meter, huh? Oh, you are having meter, then fine. Let us stick to this. Z2 minus Z1 is? Now you are saying kilometer. Huh? Okay, 4319. Meter. Okay, so now let's do 4.32 kilometers. Okay, very good. Now Z2 minus Z1 at the poles. Is it? Okay. There is one more unit which is used. Okay, so decameter, also called dam. What decameter is? 10 meter. So this is 432 dam. This is 349 dam. So now you believe that Z2 minus Z1 is more in the tropics, okay? For the same two pressure levels, 1000 and 600 HPa, compared to that in the polar region. Okay, so this brings us to some sort of closure as far as this ipsometric equation is concerned. So next class, I'll just quickly go through derivation where reduction of pressure to sea level to handling of the formula, and after that 15-20 minutes, we'll get on to the first law of thermodynamics. Okay, Cp, Cv, Q minus W equal delta U, all those things, and then we'll have to proceed to something called lapse rate. What is lapse rate? The rate of change of temperature with height. That is very, very important in atmospheric science. So we first start out with what is called the adiabatic lapse rate. We will work out the adiabatic lapse rate, which will help us in the problems.